To exist means coexist, my dear friends in Jesus Christ. The existence of unity in diversity and diversity in unity is the hallmark of religious life. In today's gospel, Jesus invites all of us to be a true Christian who is having an unconditional love towards his brother. Only a person who is having unconditional love can correct his brother and to make this world a better one. What is a man if he does not make this world a better one? Our call to religious life is a call, ultimately a call to communion and fellowship. As our constitution begins with, our call is a call to a loving community. In today's gospel, it speaks about the different ways through which we can bring back our brother. Every human being has a responsibility to correct his brother. Through this, Jesus introduces a new concept of universal brotherhood. That's why he tells us that if it is necessary, take two or three with you when you go to reconcile with your brother. Jesus also tells us to practice the virtue of an extra love, an extra walk, an extra smile to our brethren. This is called unconditional love, which does not exclude anyone from our loving communion. In our 36 general synaxes, as we were asked to reflect upon the importance of communication, community and communion. We know many times in our communities we lack communion. It's just because the lack of proper and effective communication among us. Once one of our brothers asked me, have you ever thought that how these more than 300 people who have come from different families, different cultures, different places, live together in a beautiful blending of loving communion at this garden of virtues, Dharmara. After a while, breaking my silence, he added, that is the beauty of religious community life. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, our call to religious life is a call to communion and fellowship. In these beautiful moments of meditation, let's ask ourselves a few questions. Whether are we able to enjoy our religious community life in its beauty? Are we ready to go back, to bring back, to reconcile with our brothers? If not, my dear brothers and sisters, let's take a new vow, an extra vow, a vow of community life in loving communion as our fourth vow. Let's pause for a while and pray in our hearts. Lord, give us the courage and humility to go back, to bring back, to reconcile with our fellow brethren, to lead a beautiful community life of loving communion in our religious life, as our founding father, Blessed Kuriakose Areas Chavra, inspired us to live our religious life. Amen. Thank you. Have a beautiful day ahead.